Good afternoon. Welcome to Immaculate Heart of Mary Church. Today we are celebrating the 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time. The readings can be found in your red hymnal on page 1190, that's 1190. And our opening hymn is in your blue gather, number 380, Glory and Praise to Our God, number 380. Please stand.
Our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters of sons of him who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Receive our prayer, your seed.
Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy rich food and pure choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain." The word of the Lord.
Our psalm is number 29 in your blue gathered. Shepherd me, O God, number 29.
Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. God is my shepherd, so nothing shall I want. I rest in the meadows of faithfulness and love. I walk by the quiet waters of peace. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Gently you raise me, and truth. My spirit shall sing the music of your name. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. Though I should staff, my comfort and my hope. Shepherd me, O God, beyond my wants, beyond my fears, from death into life. You have set me a banquet of love in the of hatred, crowning me with
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I know how to live in humble circumstances. I know also how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well-fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance, and of being in need. I can do all things in Him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accord with His glorious riches in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
With
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to
Jesus again, in reply, spoke to the chief priests and elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fattened cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy to come. Go out, therefore, into the main roads, and invite to the feast whomever you find.' The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad and good alike, and the hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to meet the guests, he saw a man there not dressed in a wedding garment. The king said to him, 'My friend, how is it that you came in here without a wedding garment?' But he was reduced to silence. Then the king said to his attendants, 'Bind his hands and feet and cast him into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Many are invited, but few are chosen. The Gospel of the Lord. We're given this beautiful and very confusing gospel today. And I'm here to say I don't have all the answers. But it's a parable. Again, so I've been saying this for a number of weeks, but just to say it again, it's this way that Jesus teaches to draw us in. We walk around the parable and ask questions of it. And of course, we receive as we do with it from the whole history of the church's interpretation of this mystery of the way Jesus here is revealing the kingdom and the power of the kingdom, the beauty of the kingdom. And so I have one question. So of course, just to remember the parable, we just read it, but it's this parable of the king who's throwing this great wedding feast for his son. He invites all of these people and they refuse, and so the king gets upset and he kills them all. And then he invites everybody else, sinners, good people, everybody to the feast. And then there's a strange character who is there without a wedding garment. What's a wedding garment? And he casts him outside. Okay, so just remember that story, the beauty of that story. My first question to this parable, and it's the primary question that I want to ask, and it's almost glaring, but since we've heard it so many times, we might forget or miss it. Where in the world is the bride? Where is she? The father, this king is preparing a feast, a wedding feast for his son. And where's the bride? He's inviting all of these people. It's going to be a huge party. But it feels like a bachelor party. It's a really large bachelor party. What about the bride? Where is she? There's no mention of her. It's a question that everyone there would have been asking too. It's not just like a common thing, oh, she's just being quiet, she's just in the background. It's a real question. Where is she? And of course, so many of our commentators have brought forward a great mystery that Jesus is revealing in this feast. And it's the whole feast, the great feast that our Father wants to prepare for us, even outside of the story that we hear. The bride we're meant to see is the church, which is to say, every one of us here. We can speak about the church in broad terms, and sometimes that feels like, well, that's just the church. But the church is only the bride if its members, who is all of us, are recipients of that truth. It's this mystery that God has sought. It's an analogous term, but God seeks to marry us. And that is to say, God desires to be united with us, to be united. That's the mystery of marriage here, to become even one with us. That's what he desires, and that's what God has done in his Son. And there's so much more to say about it, and I'll say a few more things about it. Now, you might hear that and think, That's just weird, okay. But it's part of the beauty of what God has revealed. That's part of salvation, is to become one with God. That's what our greatest mystical saints have spoken about, this mystical union. God desires that ultimately for every one of us, and it's for us to receive deeply. And just to put a little bit more flesh on it, what does it mean, you know, when God looks at us and says, I want to be one with you? Part of what it means is that he looks at us and desires us. That's part of, you know, we know that, of course, in marriage, that desire between a man and a woman. It's obviously different with God, but it's still his desire for us. He sees in us even more than we see in ourselves. He sees in us this tremendous capacity for us, it's a mystery, to be able to receive him. And even to speak about it, it's hard to say what I'm trying to say. But it's to receive him, it's all of his love. God sees that we are capable of receiving that love. And he wants us to receive it so that we can give it away. He says that there's something in us. Of course, he created us, but he sees that about us. And he sees us in that way as so lovely and desirable. And we're meant to look at God and to see that. He wants us so bad. Some of the saints, it's beautiful the language they put around it, but he's longing for us, like just begging, let me come in, please receive me even more deeply, with his humility, his desire for us. It's beautiful to see that in God. It's his desire to be one with us. And so it's for us, and of course, it's his love, it's everything about him. And it's also just beautiful to see. It's this mystery of the feast, because that's what's happening here, that the story here, that the king invites all of these people, the wedding guests, but they're also those who they, as we see it in our mystery, they are the ones who are going to be married to the Son. We're here speaking about the eternal Son, united with him. And how does it happen? It happens by being invited to the feast. And that's exactly what's happening for the church today, for us here, as we are united. Jesus is looking at us, yes, desiring us, but also bringing us here to the feast. And what is the feast? It's himself. It is Jesus. It's his life. The body that he gives to us, that has been given on that mount of the cross. Here he gives himself to us. And in so giving, he desires us to be filled all the way with it, all the way. Which brings us to that strange image of this man who is there without the wedding guest. And just to underline, it is without the wedding garment. He's the wedding guest, but he's there without the wedding garment. It is a strange image. What is the wedding garment? We just had a wedding earlier today. We had the bride. She was wearing a wedding dress. We had the groom. He was dressed smartly in his wedding attire because he was here to get married. The wedding garment is the garment saying, I'm here to be married. So everybody else hearing that story would have said, wait, what? He's getting married? I mean, it's a whole turn on everything. He's there to get married, and so is everybody else. So it just affirms what I'm saying. But that man, of course, did not bring the wedding garment. It's like us coming here to Mass and saying, yeah, I might come here, but I'm not interested in my life being transformed. I'm not interested in union with God. That's too much for me, or that can't happen. That's not what God really wants. God doesn't desire me. It's like us folding our arms and say, fine, you can offer that, but I don't want it, or I don't care. But here, it's a rejection of the preciousness of this gift. And so, yes, throw that man outside. He's not here for what we are being offered. And so this gospel is an invitation for us to be so rooted here when we are at Mass and to beg, you know, to come before Jesus and say, yes, 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 clothe me with yourself. Feed me. from this banquet, allow every part of me to be filled with you. And just notice it, it is his work. He is the one who is doing the marrying, and we're saying yes, but it's him to fill us, to clothe us. That's ours to say yes to it, to receive his desire, that we can be one with him, so that we can share his love with all those that we encounter outside. So the invitation today is, this is our homework for the week. It's a little imaginative exercise. What do you want your wedding garment to look like? That's paying attention to your desire. What do you want Jesus to give to you today? What are you in need of? Is it the way he sees the world? Is it his heart? Is it his ears to hear more deeply? Is it his love? You know, what do you want that to, the way that he, in what way do you want him to make you look more like him today? That's our wedding garment. What's the Lord knocking on your heart today to receive that wedding garment, to be dressed fully here, even as you receive the Eucharist, this great feast? Let's stand together and proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With confidence in our Father, we turn to him with our needs.
For the Church, that we may be relentless in extending God's invitation to every person we encounter, gathering people from every corner of the world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected leaders, that they may work to see that those at the margins of society are treated with dignity and compassion, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those here at home and around the world who are malnourished and go hungry, who never get to experience a banquet of rich food and wines, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we raise Israel and Gaza to you and pray for those suffering. We ask that you provide peace in this crisis and protection and comfort for all those who have been impacted. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may go forth from this Eucharistic banquet, nourished and inspired to share the richness of our feast with those searching for a source of hope and love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions in our parish, for Sam Miller and Katrina Mochinski, who were married in our church this weekend, for Valerie Arlene McLean, who is being baptized this weekend, for those who are sick or homebound, for those who have died, and for Jerry Gollenvau, for whom this Holy Mass is being offered, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of plenty, you invite us to your feast. Inspire us to extend that hospitality and generosity to all those we encounter as we rely on you to provide through Jesus, who is Christ our Lord. Amen.
As the gifts are being prepared, please join me in singing number 831 in your red worship as we gather at your table, number 831.
As we gather at your table, as we listen to your word, help us know, O God, your presence. Let our hearts and minds be stirred. Nourish us with sacred story till we claim it as our own. Teach us through this holy banquet how to make love's victory known. Turn our worship into witness in the sacrament of life. Send us forth to love and serve you, bringing peace where there is strife. Give us, Christ, your great compassion to forgive as you forgave. May we still behold your image in the world you died to save. Gracious Spirit, help us summon other guests to share that feast, where triumphant love will welcome those who had been last and least. There no more will envy blind us, nor will pride our peace destroy. As we join with saints and angels to repeat the sounding joy.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness, we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Bernard our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
Our communion hymn is number 596 in your blue gather. Bread for the World, number 596. Jesu, the very thought of thee with sweetness fills the breast, but sweeter far thy face to see.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. So just a few announcements. Actually, a whole page of announcements. Okay. So we're looking for someone to take... I'm grateful, actually, someone has just taken the 10 p.m. slot for adoration on Thursday. But we're still looking for one or two more, just so for safety and also just in case someone needs to take a break for a day. So if that's still in your mind, if it's in your mind to take it, you can sign up on our website by going to the adoration button on the front page. IHM will be hosting a blood drive on November 1st. Please see the bulletin for more information. IHM will host the annual Trunk or Treat event again this year on Saturday, October 28th. From 1 to 3 p.m. You can sign up to park your car in the parking lot and hand out candy during the event. You can reserve your spot at the sign-up sheet in the gather space. Our women's group, WIM, will be gathering on Monday, October 23rd at 7 p.m. Learn about several saints and taste food and beverage from the country of the saint. It's always a fun evening and all women are invited, so please bring a friend. Our remembrance luncheon will be October 26th at noon. This event did not make the bulletin, so if you'd like to join us, please call the parish office. Resource West is collecting warm winter wear for children in need in our area. There is a bin in the gather space. 55 and over game day will be gathering on Thursday, October 19th at 1 p.m. in Fireside. All are welcome to join. And then finally, all are welcome, of course, to join us for Oktoberfest following Mass today in the gym. There's bingo, food, and great beverages. You can purchase tickets in the gather space after Mass this evening. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Our closing hymn is number 506 in the Blue Gather, I Am For You. We will sing stanzas 4 and 5, number 506.
We are anointed servants of God. We have been born again of the Spirit. We are the Word, God speaks to the world. Freedom and light to all who will hear it. So let us be the Word of the Lord. I am for you. I am for you. I am for you evermore. There is a world that waits in the womb. There is a hope unborn God is bearing. Though the powers of death day our God is preparing, sing round the fire to wake in the dawn. I am for you, I am for you, I am for you, we are one. Thank you.